I wouldn't have really ever expected to see the results that we're seeing.
Chloe Jean Brower was born on August 24th, 2011. She was born with bilateral profound hearing loss.
She's never gonna hear my voice. She's never gonna hear her sister sing the lullabies to her. We've been told it's a lot of work, but our ultimate goal is to get her to spoken language.
Chloe.
Daddy.
Hi, Chloe.
Chloe
chair?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Daddy.
Yeah, Daddy's watching you listen.
What?
My puppy.
You need your puppy?
Yeah.
Go find it.
It's been a year, and I wouldn't have ever guessed that she was putting 3-4 words together. She verbalizes in words what she wants.
And the words that she uses, you know, are tough words, and she'll just rattle them off. And it's just amazing to think that not very long ago, that was not possible, you know, and all the things she would be missing if she didn't have those.
Chloe.
Move, Daddy. Move, Daddy. All right.
Chloe enjoys her cochlear implants. She doesn't sleep with them, so first thing in the morning when she realizes you have them ready for her to put on, she gets excited. The smile on her face is priceless because, to me, we made the right decision. She knows with her cochlear implants provide for her, and she is wanting that as well.
What does it say? Oh, what does clock say, Chloe?
Well, Sydney's always been a great big sister.
She's a little audiologist. She's constantly working with her.
We don't ask her to do it. She wants Chloe to be able to hear her.
My baby dear.
Your baby's there, yeah.
Every day is a learning moment. Her responding to her name, you know, when you walked in the room and said, hi, Chloe, and she would turn and look for you. That was just, you know, to me that was neat, you know, because it was like, she's got it. She's not just responding to a door slamming or something dropping on the floor, but she heard my voice and she's looking for me.
Mommy, help. Oh, mommy, help. Eyes.
I am blessed that she verbalizes her wants and demands as often as she does. But sometimes it's a little frustrating. Just like a normal, she's almost two, getting into those terrible twos, independent twos. But for her to tell me, move, mommy, when I need to step aside because she's trying to move her baby. A year ago, I didn't know, you know, what her language would be like.
It's rewarding as parents to know that hard work does pay off. And that you can look back and say, well, we didn't leave anything on the table. We did it all. And it's worked and it's paid off. And she's gonna be so much better off for that. The next step, I mean, for us is to get her in mainstream, get her started right with the rest of the kids her own age in, you know, hopefully preschool, but kindergarten for sure, you know, and keep her on track.
Bird. Ball.
I call Boys Town our family, and that's very much what they are. And you feel that when you're there. They like to hear about what Chloe's doing just as much as like you like to talk about what your child's doing. I know that if anything would ever happen that we would need them, they'd be right there.
Everybody's kind of pulling the same direction. This is the mission, and we're going to do it.
Did you hear that one?
Boys Town has a place in my heart and always will, and I will forever be thankful for them.